So one time at work, someone told me I needed to take a chill pill, which I don't understand because I am the most chill, relaxed person you will ever meet. In fact, there are only like two things that I really care about. The first being everybody and their opinion of me, and the second being the crushing existential weight of being alive. But other than that, super chill. Hey guys, John here from John on Fire, and my channel is all about personal finance and financial independence. Today I'm going to talk about the importance of financial buckets. But before I talk about financial buckets, just a quick life update. In the last 2 months, I have lost 13 pounds, so yay, health is wealth. It's lit. Yeah, life has been going really well, and I feel like I'm back on track with my FIRE goals, so things are going great. Things are going great. All right, so today we're going to talk about financial buckets. What are financial buckets? So first, financial buckets are basically just accounts that you have for a specific purpose. And I tend to categorize financial buckets in terms of timelines. So the way that I do it is that I actually have three financial buckets, one for a now fund, a soon fund, and then lastly, a later fund. So I contribute to each of these separate funds based on when I need the money. So first, let's talk about the now bucket. So the now bucket is basically the money that you have for everyday expenses, your emergency fund, and money that you don't want to risk putting in the market. It is really important that money in this bucket is safe and liquid, or at least semi-liquid. So this bucket will include your checking account, which has your everyday expenses and recurring monthly expenses like your mortgage or car payments. This bucket will also have your emergency fund. And lastly, this bucket also includes planned purchases within the next 1 to 2 years. And the reason I say that is because you don't want to have that money in the market and then the market tanks and then all of a sudden you have less money than you planned and you wanted to, let's say, go back to school or buy a new property or buy a car or some big purchase. So because of the shorter timeline, I don't want to risk that money in the market. So I put that money in like a high yield savings account so that money is accessible to me without the risk of losing it. A lot of people will consider checking accounts, high yield savings accounts, and CDs as like the type that would go into this now bucket. So the next bucket we're going to talk about is the soon bucket. And this is money that you want to like have within the next 3 to 10 years. So basically you have a higher risk tolerance than your now bucket, right? But you don't want to be hyper aggressive because you still want that money to be accessible. And even if the market dips, you still want like a majority of your capital in there. I consider this bucket to be for things that I want within the next 3 to 10 years. Let's say I'm saving for a property, but I don't plan on buying it within the next 1 to 2 years, and I have a higher risk tolerance and I want to take advantage of time in the market. So I'll put money in a more conservative allocation. Personally, my risk tolerance tends to be a little bit higher. So I actually put money in a moderate allocation portfolio. That's like a mix of stocks and bonds, like fixed income. The important thing is that it's like a conservative to moderate allocation. I also plan on going back to school. I think I actually touched up on this, but my true passion is health policy. And eventually, I do want to go back and get a master's in public policy and a doctorate in health policy, because that's the reason why I'm doing this FIRE journey anyway, is because I really genuinely want to improve our healthcare system. So yeah, in short, the money that I'm saving for those kinds of goals, a new property or going back to school or whatnot, house, wedding, car, whatever, I'm going to put into this bucket so that it's accessible to me. And because it's more conservative, if the market tanks, I still have a majority of the capital that I put in there. And finally, the last bucket that we're going to talk about is the later bucket. So the later bucket is for money that you don't plan on touching for like 10 plus years, right? And this would be an aggressive allocation, or even hyper-aggressive if you feel so inclined. I include retirement accounts in here, so like your 401k or 403b, your traditional or Roth IRA, money that you don't plan on touching for the long term, I have in an aggressive allocation, and that goes in the later bucket. Another thing that goes in this bucket is my financial freedom fund, my FIRE fund. I have an aggressive allocation, and basically it's like the majority of it is just like pure stocks. Now, the important thing here is, yes, it's aggressive, but you still want to be diversified. For my example, personally, I tend to be very heavy in tech, but I'm still diversified in the energy, finance, and utility sectors as well. I also own some REITs. I have some international funds. But the important thing is that this bucket, you want to be aggressive, right? Because you want that money to grow. So let's talk about how I personally manage my money using this concept of financial buckets. So for my now bucket, this is funds that I have that are safe and liquid, or at least semi-liquid. This includes my checking account where my mortgage and car payments come from, as well as my utility payments. And this also includes my emergency fund, which I have in a high yield savings account. And this will also include planned purchases that I will have in the next 1 to 2 years. So if I'm saving for a house and I'm kind of like reaching the precipice of deciding, yes, I want to buy a house within the next 1 to 2 years, I'm gonna stop contributing the money to the soon bucket and start just saving money in the now bucket, if that makes sense. Next is my soon bucket. And for me personally, I have two accounts, my Northwestern Mutual and my M1 Finance account, in which they are in a more conservative to moderate allocation. And this is money that I'm putting away for like school, a car eventually, even though I just bought a new car, like eventually I'm gonna need a new car. And like new rental properties that I want to acquire in the future, that's going in the soon bucket because that's not like something that I'm gonna buy within the next 1 to 2 years, but I still wanna take advantage of the market and I have a higher risk tolerance. And finally, how I see my later bucket is that's all of my retirement accounts. So my 401k, my Roth, and my traditional IRAs from my past employment, that goes in here, and my financial freedom or my lean FIRE fund, that's what I'm putting in my later bucket, and that's all aggressive. So yeah, guys, that is the concept of financial buckets. And the important thing is, regardless of which bucket you're putting your money into, make sure you diversify. Until next time, bye.